Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new episode of Microsoft Sentinel in the Field, where we bring you the latest and greatest of our favorite SIEM product. If you don't want to miss any episode, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also follow our playlist in the link that you can see below. As always, I have with me my great colleague, Chris. Hey, Chris, what's up?
Hey, Javier. Hey, everyone. So today we have a very special guest, Priti Krishna from the Sentinel product group, to talk to us about the content management and specifically about the new or not so new Content Hub. Welcome, Priti.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.
So Priti, can you explain to the audience a little bit why content management is important in a SIEM and what is the role that Content Hub specifically plays within Microsoft Sentinel?
Great question, Javier. Let's first introduce what is content in this context. So first off, like we are talking about SIEM content, which is a security information and event management system content for that, which includes data connectors, which is all about like ingesting data into Sentinel and enabling those ingest capabilities. Once you have the data, then it's all about like how can you build out analytics, and that is analytic rules becomes another type of content as well. Similarly, how can you then start like kind of responding on those alerts and all via automations, which is via playbooks in Microsoft Sentinel. So it's about enabling those capabilities. How can you hunt for different kinds of threats and attacks in your enterprise? And that's where hunting queries is yet another type of content in Sentinel. So all of these are termed, as we're terming as content, how can we enable you to actually leverage these content at scale and enable you to customize these instead of you creating all this content from scratch for different scenarios? That's where Content Hub comes into picture, where you can actually onboard content of different types for your scenarios, and you can get content on demand.
So Priti, first of all, thanks a lot. I definitely want to highlight something. You know, part of Microsoft Sentinel, we do have the ability to make sense of the data that we bring in because we have a lot of content that's already out of the box that we can use. Now, I can imagine it can be a very daunting task to browse through that long list of content. How do we help our customers to navigate through all that?
Great, great point, Chris. It's like if you just throw a bunch of out-of-box content, it's really hard to like make sense out of it. And that's where all these categorization and filtering capabilities by content types. Like suppose if you are really looking for a data ingest scenario, yeah, you can filter by content type as data connectors. You can even further like granularize your search for certain scenarios. Like I want to search for content in network category and you get a bunch of those solutions. So another aspect is also solutions, which is bundling of these content to enable a certain product scenario, which is kind of like working in a certain product. Suppose if you are working on Microsoft Defender scenarios and you want to integrate with that with Microsoft Defender logs, then you can get a solution for Microsoft Defender. So that is actually a product solution example. Similarly, there are domain solutions. Suppose you have you want to look for, say, the latest and greatest on Log4j attack. What is happening there? How can I get a package for that? Then you can search for that, and then you can get a bunch of solutions that actually meet those needs and onboard or install based on your scenarios. Similarly, like there are solutions for vertical scenarios, like if you're looking for finance sector or healthcare sector. So this is all like solutions enable you to get a scenario-driven search powered by all the filtering capabilities that's available in Content Hub.
Very good, Priti. I've heard that there's a bunch of new things announced lately around Content Hub. Could you summarize for the audience what is new and how it benefits our customers and partners?
Good. So thanks for raising this. And this is where like kind of we have what we used to have before when we launched Content Hub was all the solutions would actually install active items in your galleries directly. So whenever we used to do an update to the solution, it will create more duplicate copies of those Azure resources. So which was not a very optimal experience. So now actually the new range of solutions enable better lifecycle management capabilities because you're packaging content templates. So all these updates, whenever you install a solution, it'll actually land your templates in the right template galleries, and then you can actually go ahead and create active items out of that and customize them. So better lifecycle management is in the sense like if you have an update, then the template gets updated in place rather than creating dupes in your workspace. So that is actually a very a cool thing. And furthermore, we have enabled kind of content management capabilities in Sentinel itself. So after you install a solution, you can start looking at the content that got installed along with the solution. And you can start working on creating new active items and using that content. And you can even delete ones that you don't need. So
Excellent. This all sounds great. Thank you so much, Kriti. Javier, I got a question for you. What time is it?
Of course, Chris, it's demo time.
It is demo time.
So here we are in Content Hub, and it's in the Sentinel. You can find it under Content Management. So Content Hub enables you to get all out-of-box content items based on your scenarios. We spoke quite a bit about filtering capabilities and all, and these are the filters that I was talking about. Currently, we have like over 200 solutions in Content Hub, just crossed 200, so that's a cool milestone now.
Congrats.
Thank you. And in the status is one thing, when you install solutions, you can view by installed solutions or not installed ones or new solutions that we just launched and it's available for you to check out. Solutions where updates are available as well is flagged. So that's there too. Out here, you can also like look at Microsoft supported versus kind of like partner supported solutions too. So that's yet another pivot. And definitely providers as well. So there are a bunch of different data providers that we support in Sentinel, and category, which is a cool thing where you can actually search by your scenarios. So suppose if you're looking for an identity solution or compliance or different types of security pivots are there as well for you to search by, and vertical scenarios too.
Actually, Priti, I do have a question for you. You know, one of the great things part of the Content Hub is that it's very rich when it comes to content. Can you talk about how we added NIST as a package to the Content Hub and how that's super critical for many customers out there?
Awesome. So yeah, we have actually the NIST solution that includes a bunch of analytic rules, playbooks, and workbooks. And it actually enables our compliance teams and all to kind of get a good assessment around and monitoring and remediations around their NIST scenarios. So this is something that we partnered with experts, compliance experts across in Microsoft, and built this out by packaging the right set of detections and playbooks and workbooks. So there's also a solutions build guide that we have published for our partners and other teams to also publish different types of solutions. And do tend to leverage that if you have a solution in mind to publish.
Excellent, thank you.
So going ahead, you can see that there are all these different types of solutions. There are some featured solutions as well. You can see Log4j, SAP, Teams, and that you can try out. And the featured list also rotates. Basically, like we have different types of cloud scenario solutions as well, like AWS and Oracle and in Azure, of course. So let's take a look at one of these installed solutions. We can see the version of the solution. I want to actually call attention to this because these are the latest ones, like the new version of 2.0 solutions have a managed view. There are older solutions where it is version 1.1 series, and those won't have a content management view. So that is one thing to note. And we have a few version 1 solutions and the process of updating everything to 2.0 currently. So that's one difference we want to just call out. Let's look at the new managed view. I'll also show the install experience for solutions too. Like in general, the solution install, if you want to onboard a solution, like in this case, AWS, you can just go ahead and click install. And you can see the solution description and what content it has. All of that is there. And the data connection actually leverages HTTP Data Connector API. We can also visualize that. Then go ahead with install. Install actually opens up the wizard where you can actually see the steps in terms of plans that the solution offers, and even usage information and support as well, where you can go and click on support links if you have any questions. This is a cool thing, reviews. So if you like a solution, definitely please provide and write your review, provide your ratings. This is how we can have a good like feedback loop and can enable different scenarios too. So you can go ahead and create the solution. It will just launch a step-by-step guided wizard for you to install the solution. In this case, you can just select the workspace that you want to install it to. And pretty much with the version kind of $2 solutions, you'll just see like more information about each of the content types, but no inputs are needed to actually enable the installation of the solution per se, except for the workspace. So once you do this, it's just go ahead and create, which would just trigger the ARM deploy process, and it would just get the solution installed. So in the interest of time, I will actually skip the installation, but once you go ahead and create it, it'll install all the templates that the solution carries, and finally it also shows up as installed. Now let's look at one of the solutions that is installed. I'll go to the install solutions, and that has the manage view. This is version 2.0, so going to manage. And this is the new experience that we've also announced recently. So manage would actually open up the list of content that is included in the solution. So in this case, I'm already ingesting Azure Activity Logs. So if I just click on this, this is the data connector. I'm going to minimize this one just in the interest of real estate. We can see that this is the data connector that is included in this solution. I see that it's in use because I'm already ingesting this. And I can see immediately a snapshot of what is the ingest pattern and what are the data types and whether it's connected, what is the last heartbeat. So I get it at a glance, like what is happening with this, my data connectivity, and then what's my last log received as well.
So Priti, this is the same data connector that I used to have in the data connectors gallery, right?
Yes, it is indeed. So I can even go and click on Open Connector page, which will directly take me to the Data Connector Gallery view of the same thing, where I can again work on details if I want to.
Very good.
So I have both the options there. So similarly, like if suppose the Data Connector were not connected, I would see a triangle out here mentioning that go ahead and connect this Data Connector, follow the configuration guidelines in the Data Connector page when you open it, and establish connectivity. So once I establish connectivity, the content becomes in use. Similarly, for analytic rules, these are all templates. So that's why like unless you create an active item and enable the rule, it is not in use. So these are a couple of rules that I've already enabled. However, if I want to enable, I can just go directly to this item. It'll take me to the analytics gallery guided experience where I can go ahead and enable this rule. And then the orange triangle vanishes, the warning vanishes pretty much, and I get an in-use tag there. This is a template that we just loaded, and we can just go ahead and create rule, and it's business as usual. It'll just open up the analytic rules creation wizard, the guided experience to get you to create your rule. So just going back here, once the rule is created, it will actually turn back to in use. And then you also have a link directly to the active item that you created to navigate directly to that. So that's that can help kind of like complete your experience where you can directly go to this rule and then customize it further. So similarly, like when you look at hunting queries, see there's no triangle out here. And let's see why. That's because like there, the hunting queries, you don't need to create or activate it. It's already there, and you just have to run the query. So I can actually go ahead and you can see the hunting query completely out here and what the query does and before you choose to run it. So in this case, like if I just go here, I can just run my query in view, in context. So I'm just running this query and I can get, oh, the 17 results. If I click on this, I'll directly go to the log analytics workspace with the result details and can work through that. So it's very easy to start working with your content immediately and get started. Similarly, if I want to go ahead and create, customize this hunting query, I can click on this and then directly go to the hunting template itself and clone my template, which creates this one item for me. I can customize the query as much as I want to and work with it in the hunting gallery experience. So with that, then similarly, workbooks. Just going to workbook, again, you don't have to like create a copy or customize it or enable it. So I can just go ahead and view the template. It'll just load all my information out here. So yeah, clicking on that workbook, it just loads with the data that had ingested. So pretty much like I can just use and view the workbook right in context without enabling. Similarly, playbooks will also need to be enabled and configured and activated before you can use it. So if I had a playbook in this solution, I would see an orange triangle and it'll take me to the playbooks gallery to activate that playbook from the templates. So that's basically, in a nutshell, the manage view. There's also an option like, suppose if I don't want this analytic rule and it's just causing a lot of clutter in my workspace, I can go ahead and select a bunch of these and then go ahead and delete them at scale as well. Similarly, reinstall is an option which would, since I deleted, I want to bring them back. Reinstall will just trigger the solution install experience and will bring back all my content items.
Got it. So when I delete, it only removes that created content column, basically, that has one item. I would have zero items, but then I can recreate again the rule if I want to, right?
That's a great question. So if I so delete actually deletes only the content templates that came in with the solution currently. It doesn't delete your active items that is associated with that template.
Oh, okay.
If I just go ahead and do a delete on this, it will actually, there's one more selected in the bottom, the workbook as well. That's why it's 5. It'll delete the templates, but it will not delete any existing active content item currently. And we are trying to learn a bit more about the scenario before we can enable this in future cycles, part of the roadmap.
Very good, thanks.
Similarly, coming back, there are also actions available at a solution level. Suppose like I don't want the solution, I can go ahead and delete the solution as well. And reinstall solution just brings back the deleted content items and I get the whole solution back again. So these are two controls at a solution level that's available for deleting a solution if I don't want, and you can on demand get it back again.
So Priti, thanks a lot for the demo. Very clear. Can you tell us a little bit about what is coming? What is next for Content Hub?
That's a good question. And actually, what we are starting, we are looking at completing the centralized discovery in Content Hub for all the content types. So currently, like as we are seeing, there are 200 plus solutions. The content that is included in these solutions are also appearing in the feature galleries. Like you'll see the hunting queries appearing in the hunting gallery. It creates kind of a duplicative and a fragmented experience in general for our customers. So we are trying to clean that up a bit in terms of finishing up content migration. So that is a key thing that is coming soon. And that's a top of mind roadmap item. At the same time, like once we complete centralized discovery, there's also like options to bulk manage like content at scale. So that is also another thing that's a part of the roadmap.
Just a follow-up question here, Priti. Do we have any sort of focus when it comes to the scenarios that are going to be supported in as part of the roadmap? Is there anything specific that we're focusing on?
Yeah, definitely. That is a key focus. So currently we have 200 solutions plus solutions. The plan is to actually add more content and enrich it in different categories. There's going to be more and more in that based on feedback from our customers and also what we learn in terms of new attack patterns and vulnerabilities that we want to have solutions for, similar to Log4j. So there'll be more in that area, so stay tuned.
Excellent.
Awesome. So Priti, thank you so much for coming to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thanks for having me here.